All right. Tell you what, let's go ahead and get started. I don't know what you guys remember of last week, and for the sake of our viewers, I will go
Two
ahead
weeks.
and do a recap. 2 weeks, that's right, it's been 2 weeks. Two fucking weeks. All right. So, last time, what occurred was you discovered the murdered body of your former compatriot, Lord Fallen, in his hotel room, brutally stabbed. You managed to talk to some people in town, found that there are some various things you could do while you're here. Gundren is still out there somewhere, you're not really sure where. And also that there is a local gang of sorts who are bullying lots of people in town. They're basically throwing their weight around, trying to cause a lot of trouble. So, that being said, you guys, in exploring the town, found that there was a manor up on the hill to the east. It is known as Tresdenar Manor. I don't know if you actually found that out at all, but I think you did. I think you did. So, you decided, you know what? Fuck all these responsibilities and possible quests. We're just gonna go check out the manor house because it's up there. And went up the road. As soon as you were going around, kind of eyeing the place, going up to the gate, scouting the fence, the surrounded the manor grounds, you were approached by a group of people that you could readily recognize, especially when they identified themselves as Red Brands, the very same group who is bullying this town. They told you to get lost. You said, no, make me, and a fight ensued. And after setting one of them on fire and pushing him off a cliff, and dispatching another one while he was being held prisoner, you just killed. He was being held. He was literally just being held in a chokehold, and you just stabbed him. You just outright killed him. Because killing prisoners is what you guys do. That's your thing.
Well, keep doing
And
good if it doesn't work ever. It's called his
you
fault.
now have nobody that you are aware of, barring your approach to the manor.
Interesting. Also, just to add a character, Long Live Windows. My laptop just decided to do a forced restart. So I don't have visibility on chat. So if you guys see any questions that pop up.
Awesome. Yeah, I got your chat open. I'll watch.
All right. Yeah, we got it. yeah, Wolf, I don't know if you could possibly take responsibility for all the bad words.
All of them. I take
that's
responsibility for
gonna
all of them.
that's gonna be hard.
Well, except for
That's
the
gonna.
F-bomb you dropped during the
Yeah.
explanation. All the other ones
Yeah, exactly.
I'll take responsibility
Okay.
for.
One thing also, before we really get started, that I want to draw attention to, this coming Saturday is Extra Life Day. And if you people don't
Right.
know what Extra Life is, this is a charity that benefits the Children's Miracle Network Hospitals. It is a big deal, it is a big thing. Groups across the country, across the world, maybe even, I'm not certain, are going to be gaming, are going to be working together to raise money for the Children's Miracle Network. And the Archetype Gaming group is one of those. In fact, we are one of the what? Where are we at right now? I think we're actually a bit low. We were like in the top 10, and I think we've dropped a
We're
bit.
11th last I checked.
Yeah, I think we're like 37 now. So we gotta get on
What?
that.
Slacking.
That's
Double check
yeah.
that. We're slacking.
Yeah. So in my channel, I've got my banner. I also have included below in the cards that you'll find below the Twitch, I have a link
Be right
to
back,
my
guys.
donation page. If you like what you are seeing here, please go to twitch.tv/webadatgames. That's WEBADAT
Thank you.
games. And the first card at the top left underneath the stream is a donation link. You can click on that icon or on that graphic. It'll take you to. Please, if you like what you're seeing, go donate for the kids. For the kids. And if you
Where
guys
is the
have
kids?
donation links, if you guys have donation links you want to put up as well, feel free to please do so on your
We
channels.
are number 12 right now,
We're number 12. Okay,
but
well, that's
we're on the
good.
front
That's good.
page.
Front page.
Good work, everyone. You guys are awesome.
I mean, we're getting beat by people that are obviously going to beat us, like Reddit and
Reddit.
Rooster Teeth.
Yeah, well, Rooster Teeth is working with us, so.
Our thing. I mean, they're one of our sponsors.
That's, yeah. And, Zofi points out of over 5,100 teams, be number 12.
Yeah. We're kind of badass.
My God.
A little bit.
So, yeah.
That's Zofi,
don't do anything for me. Do it for the kids. TriCap, yes, you're on it. Okay. So, and I, guys, just so you're aware, I'm going to drop that little advertisement there in a few different spots tonight. Just so if there's a lull, I'll probably just be like, by the way, if you're enjoying what you're seeing here. All right.
Yeah, sounds good. And while I've got you guys here as well, on Saturdays, I'm not, I didn't end up participating in Extra Life this year, but I do want to make sure you guys get promotions and stuff. And on Saturday, I typically do my Social Saturdays multiplayer games. And I don't know what everyone's stream schedule is like, but if you guys want to do certain things, like maybe segments with different games where I could feature you guys, and then I can promote you guys through that too.
So Zofi and I and Reed will be at an event, a 24-hour LAN party in Kansas City. So I think it's pretty much just... welfare.
Oh, you guys aren't going to be broadcasting it? It's just local?
It's going to be broadcasted on the front page of Twitch.
That's true.
I think periodically.
Yeah.
With the other Extra Life events that are going on. So
gotcha.
I know that event's going to be broadcasted with all the fighting games and stuff. I will be...
Our fighting game tournament will be going.
Yeah, I'm going to be excessively late to my stream, but I will do a 24-hour full stream. I just have a ton of stuff I got to take care of around noon on next Saturday. But I'll be streaming. So, Megna, if you want to hook up and do some gaming, I'm completely down.
Okay, sweet.
Yeah, I'm sure we have several people that are going to be streaming throughout the event.
Yep. Be sure you stock up on no-dos, Wolf. And don't get sick.
Yeah, no getting sick.
Don't catch those Ebolas. They'll fuck you up.
I got 6 Ebolas right now. I'm good.
So oh, too soon. Hashtag too soon.
51 people that are going, which take into account people are probably going to bring 2 or 3 friends with them. So it's not beyond the imagination that we'll have over 500 people that that'll show up.
We'll just have to see, because we had to change venues, so it's...
That's also true.
Apparently, the Magic tournament got basically castrated. Like, they're still having one, but long story short, sponsorship fell through. So, but they're doing a Hearthstone event, which is going to be big. And they are doing an X-Wing event, tabletop X-Wing, and I will be running D&D games, while we're there as well as having my own computer. So, yeah, rock on. Alrighty, let's get this shizzle on the rizzle.
All right.
you guys are standing. I know. I am one of the whitest people you'll ever meet, except maybe you, Magna. I don't know. I don't think I can beat bagged milk. That's
pretty white bread right there.
Oh, yeah. Come on. Hey, yeah. We have chocolate bagged milk too. Let's not play that.
Deep chocolate bagged milk. Mm-hmm. All right. You guys are standing in front of the gates to a manor house that appears to be, for all intents and purposes, abandoned and half destroyed.
What time of day is it right now?
Right now, as I recall, it is middle of the day, maybe about noonish.
Oh yeah, we're all drunk too.
I'm not.
Wait, what?
We were drunk before we started that fight.
Yeah, we were drinking like all morning.
That's true. If I'd remembered that, I would have given you guys disadvantage on a few rolls. Oh, excuse me. Excuse me. Whew. There's the
Alrighty.
Alcohol right there. Speaking. I apologize for that there. Right there.
Okay, so guys, I think first things first, we should probably hide these bodies. I doubt these were the only red bands in the area, and we should probably dispose of the evidence right quickly.
Damn, that's spam though. Sorry, OC.
Yeah, you got. Ooh. So you have two bodies. The third is blackened and at the bottom of the hill.
There were four total, though.
Which side? Oh, okay. I thought, for some reason, I thought there were three. You're right. There are four. So, anyway, okay, you have three bodies. You have three bodies.
Well, we got three of us here, so I guess let's take them and throw them and, you know, hide them inside these ruins.
We can.
Is that the best approach?
Well, here's the thing. I don't know if anyone uses this building a lot, right? We haven't had a chance to check it out yet. So I think for the time being, maybe we should just drag them into the bushes over here, and we'll just leave them there. And then if everything looks clear, it doesn't look like it's been used in a while, we'll move them inside.
That works. I agree with that.
All right. And later, then, you can bury them, Mr. Undertaker.
I want to hang them in the trees.
Yeah, I thought you only buried bodies that you were paid for anyways, right?
Deserved it?
Yeah. The other ones just get left or hung.
Nice. You're just a sweetie.
Alrighty, okay. I'm gonna grab the first body, and I drag him over to those bushes.
Okay. And guessing the other you other two are grabbing bodies as well, dragging them.
Yes, we're dragging the others.
Yep.
All right. So now you have a taking care of those bodies. Now what?
We'll leave it up to Paulina. Paulina's our leader now.
Great, thanks. I think we need to investigate this building. So we should probably be light on our feet. We don't know what's in here. It looks undisturbed, but we should probably check for, I personally want to investigate the area, see if I can see any tracks, see anything that seems out of the ordinary, seems like it's been recently used.
Are you talking outside or inside the house?
Just on the outside, like entranceways, or I see there's some broken areas here, just look for maybe some footprints, that sort of thing.
Should probably check that little shed or barn or whatever that is in the back.
It's probably a good idea.
All right. Well, let's see. Let me get you to roll a nature check, please. Or an investigation check, up to you.
Just Magna or all three of us?
Whoever is searching the area for signs of passage.
I'll do investigation.
All right. Anybody else?
Nope.
I'll take that as a no. Oh, there it is. Okay, we got a 9. All right. Nice.
Sorry, guys. I think this is on the...
Paulina, you actually see what appears to be a trail that has been wiped away. But there is enough telltale markings of that. You can't actually see the footprints, but you can see that somebody has not completely eradicated, or rather left evidence of eradication. They did a pretty good job, but not as good as they thought.
Right,
and
okay.
That passage is leading into the front door of the manor house.
Interesting. Well, guys, I explained this to the rest of the party, and I say, guys, I think we should be careful in our approach. We don't know. There could be someone in here right now, or there could be someone who frequents this area. If you guys want, maybe we could sneak around the back, try and find another way in.
Sounds good.
Okay. And sorry, guys, I'm also just updating my T-notifier and everything here.
Let me get some stealth checks from you, then.
stealth check.
Eight. Mmm. 21. Okay.
Do you guys are you guys doing Dark Souls fat rolls like across the lawn, or what's going on? My goodness.
Certainly not very stealthy. They're stepping on every twig, including ones you thought weren't there. They somehow managed to find them. But you get around to the back, you can actually see that a large portion of the wall is just knocked down as you're walking around the side.
Yeah, which side are we approaching from?
I'm assuming you're approaching around the right side, the south side. That's what I assumed. If you want to do the north, that's fine. It's up to you guys.
It's up to Magna. He's the stealthy one.
No, that's fine. Where we're going is fine. Q.
The north, the south one? Okay. Because that's closer to the path. All right. So, approaching that side, you can see that massive hole that's there in the roof and in the wall. Not seeing any evidence, actually, of passage back here. And in terms of other entrances, well, you've got the freaking hole in the wall. There's a servant's entrance around the back. Other than that, why don't I get an investigation check from you guys to see if you can find anything else?
Alrighty.
Oh, we wasted a 20. And there's a 20.
Reed needs to get here so he can take his dice back.
Wait a minute. I clicked it. Hold on. There we go.
It was 24.
Oh,
24,
man. Yep. All right. You do not find any other passages back here. No other entrances.
Even with Wolf's 20?
You do not find any passages or other paths. And in fact, I will say with Wolf's 20 that you can determine that there is no passage. Nobody's been walking around here either.
Okay, great. And sorry, there's a doorway back here. The servants.
There is
entrance,
a servants' quarters entrance. Yes, yes, there is.
Okay, so I'm gonna go up and I'm checking the door just to see if it's open, like if it's locked or unlocked at this point.
As you test the door, it falls in.
Very sturdy.
You know, I did have the high stealth roll.
But this was funny.
As I test the lock, as I test the lock, Alafa fat rolls through the door. No. All right. So I look back and obviously this is not the most quiet approach we've ever had, but it's open. So I step into the room, the first part of the room.
I won't do that to you. I'll let you catch the door.
Okay,
it falls, but
my
it...
quick reflexes.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so I've caught the door. I push it to the side and I step in. Describe what I'm seeing. Is it dark? Is there light coming in through the roof? What do I see?
Hang on a second, Paulina. Is this where those tracks are pointing towards, or are they going farther?
No,
the tracks.
Tracks were
at the
front of the house.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
What you see is basically as dilapidated a house as you would expect to find. It is the kitchen, basically. This is the kitchen's area of the manor house. And it is, if you ever played like Fallout 3, kind of looks like that without any of the technology, basically. Everything is just rotting or breaking down in some fashion. It has been ill-kept for what looks like a very long time, decades. this has been exposed to the elements. You even think you hear some skittering in some of the cabinetry. It's too big, too loud to be insects. Some other small animal probably has made a nest in there.
All right, fair enough. So at this point, how big would you say this room is?
This particular room is going to be about 20 by 20.
Okay. And do we have other entranceways? Are there, other doorways, etc.?
There is two doorways. There are two doorways. And they both have no door essentially left. You can tell that once upon a time they had doors. But now not. One appears to be opening into a large dining area, and the other seems to go into a small, thin hallway.
Okay. Well, guys, what do you want to investigate first?
Doesn't really matter to me.
Do you guys want to split up so we can cover more ground? Do you want to?
No.
All right.
God, no.
Let me get investigation checks from all of you again. I know. More.
So many dice on my screen. Yeah, I didn't mean to double click that. My bad.
All right. Actually,
I'm doing well with Chica. How are you?
Oh no, I see it. Okay, so you guys did pretty well, just not Sophie. Jeez, that dice hate you, man. Okay. Universe. So you, as you go through the house, there are upper floors. You can't really reach them because the stairs have completely rotted away. And you search through the first floor, that ground floor of the house, and it is empty. It is vacant. Nothing here is of any worth, and you don't see any evidence of anybody having lived here anytime recently. The only evidence you see is a continued swept away, but not fully swept away, passage of boots leading down into a cellar. Or I guess it's a lean downstairs, leading downstairs. It'll be pretty obvious it's a cellar.
Gotcha. All right, well, I guess we have two options. We can kind of poke around the rest of the building first, if you want, or we can head downstairs. What do you guys think?
Well, sounds like nothing's really on the first floor, and sounds like the second floor hasn't really been accessed by, anyone as of late. So it sounds like, if we're going to be staying and looking through the inside, we might as well go downstairs.
Or we could just burn the whole building down and see what happens.
I'm down for burning the building. Let's do it.
All over in fire.
I mean, we will never find that secret passageway that leads out of the city in the basement. But let's burn it down.
Why not? It would clear the whole... It would clear everything. It'd be perfect.
Could smoke the whoever's downstairs out.
Let's do it. Let's burn it all down.
It's probably a terrible idea.
Probably.
All right.
Yeah,
Are you going to burn it down? Are you going to do it?
I vote yes.
Decide.
Well, okay. So here's two things I'm thinking of. Part of me wants to, just because my love for chaos, but the other part of me, I'm concerned if there is some good treasure or something of value that I could pawn off somewhere, I might like that better. So I propose we take a quick gander downstairs and see what's going on.
We're all gonna die.
It's true.
What happened, Magna? Paulna, you had the balls to burn down the building, and now you're in it. You're trying to get greedy.
I got greedy, yeah.
Greed gets people killed.
So it was taking hostages.
All right. So I guess since we're all still sneaking, I'll go first. I'll start slowly making my way down the stairways into the cellar.
Oh. No burning down the house. Burning down the house.
The roof. The roof is on fire. All
right.
Finish it. Finish it, Paul. Finish the words.
We don't need no. What is it? Water. We don't need no water.
We don't need no water.
Let the mother father burn.
Ah, damn it. So close.
Okay, so, I expect this much. Do I need a light source at this point? Is it, you know, am I able to see still?
So, what is the order? If he's front, who's next?
Crap. Anytime order's important,
what?
You know there's going to be a problem.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Got it. All right. So, Palna, as you are going down, it does get dark. You are going to have to light a torch or something. Once you do, however, you will be able to tell that there are oil lamps ensconced on the wall, that they are extinguished, but they have oil in them.
Okay. With my fingers, I'm gonna try and touch the wick, and I just want to see if it's warm, if it's been recently extinguished, if it's, you know, just.
It is not warm.
Okay, very cool. Well, I guess I'll light the lamp.
Okay.
And
all right.
The lamp explodes.
Let there be light. The whole place burns down.
No. Brilliance of light explodes across your retinas. It just lights up.
It was a magic lamp.
Yep. Working lamp. And it is, it's a working oil lamp. Now what?
Okay, so, obviously they're not connected, so I'll continue to make my way down the stairs, lighting the lamps as I go.
Okay.
I make it safely to the bottom of the stairs.
Yes.
Doesn't crumble beneath your feet.
And as you do, we shift.
Q, can you just out of character question here?
Yes.
For a D&D noob still, if I'm going through progression, like let's say I want to say, hey, I get down the stairs safely. What sort of, you know, at what point is it my call that I got down the stairs safely, and at what point? Because I don't want to give too much story without I don't know what you're dealing with and what I'm going to be dealing with. So,
good question.
What are creative liberties?
Good question. So, I am not going to be offended or upset in any way. If you want to start filling in gaps, if it doesn't fit with what is in the game, with what is in my head, I will correct you. So as long as you're all right with being corrected, I'm all right with you filling in some gaps.
Awesome. Awesome. Okay.
Take that initiative.
Thank you.
And I don't mean actually roll initiative.
Too late. Damn.
You waste your 20, aren't you?
Not gonna do that.
Now, let's see here.
That black map, though.
You fine gentlemen, what was your status at the end of the last fight? Who got, you guys got hurt pretty bad, didn't you?
Yeah.
I didn't get touched.
Probably
the lightning.
Did you, Wolf, did you update your character?
When? My character hasn't been updated in forever.
Like
I think I'm missing like 7 spells. Like, it's pretty bad.
You probably should do that.
Yeah.
Did we figure out your hit points?
I think I'm at 4 hit points.
Never lost any health the last fight.
I don't think, you haven't leveled up at all, have you?
Probably not now.
No, you haven't. All right. Well, we're waiting on what's his name anyway, so let's do a
quick. That's sad.
quick reconnoiter of your level 2.
Yay!
Go to the class tab, would you please? I apologize, guys. You guys all right if we do that? If we take a second for this?
Sure, that's fine.
Megan's very unhappy about this situation right now.
No, I'm fine.
All right. And you are Warlock, correct?
Si, senora.
All right. On your class tab, your Warlock, see it says class levels, you got Warlock, and it says 1. Please up that to 2.
All right.
And then here on your core stats page, we need to add your hit points. You can either add 1d8.
Oh, I should probably move this up.
So 3. So you can either add 1d8 plus 3 hit points, but you have to roll it. And you can reroll once, but you have to keep 2s.
That's what I did. It was a terrible decision.
You can take 5 plus your con mod, so 8 total. What do you want to do?
Hey, the artisan, what's going on, dude?
So I can roll for more hit points or just go straight up?
Yep.
Z-Fall, welcome to the channel, man. Good to see ya.
All right, so it would be a 1d8 if I rolled it.
Standing Wolf, yes. No worries. It's a crazy game, isn't it? It's so
and
much
we'll
fun.
And we'll add 3 to that.
My goodness.
Bottom mod.
I can't wait for Don't Starve Together. All it's right. Going to be a great addition to Social fun. Saturdays.
Add 6 to your maximum.
All right, done.
And make sure your current is at there.
Excuse
well.
Me.
I did.
All right. Okay. Let's see.
Yeah, chocolate filled croissants sound really good. I actually, we got some raspberry turnovers today. They're so good. I love them. And Mrs. Magnus baking. Level. Actually, she already baked a pumpkin loaf, which is delicious
second
and amazing.
Level, yeah,
so
second
she's
level
got
is
that in the window.
For
it's cooling.
You
Andrew, you missed
called,
a little bit.
You get something called Eldritch Invocations. You have to pick from...
I'm just going to go ahead and mute Raid Call for a second and chat with you guys. So what's happened so far? We're still injured after our fight. We've hidden the bodies, the red band bodies that we found last time. Or that we, I guess, put there because that was our fault. Red brands, rather. And we have started investigating this broken down building. I looked around and I ended up finding that there was a trail leading in the front door, but it looks like it had been covered up, but not very well. We went around the back, made it inside the building. Basically, the top floor looks useless. There's nothing going on, but we found these tracks that lead down to the cellar. And so we're right now in the process of going down into the cellar. We're going to check things out. We contemplated maybe burning down the entire place, but I'm worried we're going to miss some treasure. So I haven't done that. Yeah, raspberry's great, Poxy. It's so good. But yeah, that's sort of where we left off. And in the meantime, what's happening right now, because Wolf hasn't had his character upgrade to level 2 yet, Hugh is just running through with Wolf getting that character upgraded. I should send all my mods coffee crisp. Maybe. I would need to know where everyone lives for that. Yeah, well, if you share chocolate croissants, I would definitely share a raspberry turnover. That seems fair. Pay you in Canadian candy. Is it worth considerably less than American candy? Bodacious. I actually just got my new water filter in the other day and I thought of you. It came in and I was like, huh. Bodacious doesn't have one of these. You guys. Hey, Momo. What's up, man? I'm going to go grab a quick snack while this is going on.
I didn't think any of them were
I'll be back.
Crap. No, this is different. So I tell you what, for now, we're going to say this. We're going to say, your Eldritch Blast, you're going to add your Charisma modifier to the damage when it hits. So we're going to say you're adding 3 to your Eldritch Blast damage. And we are going to say for now that your other one okay is you can use your action to touch a willing humanoid and perceive through its senses until the end of your next turn.
Nice.
As long as the creature is on the same plane of existence as you, you can use your action on subsequent turns to maintain this connection. You don't have to be able to touch, you don't have to continue touching them.
All right, how what's the range on that? How close do I need to be? Like right next to him?
You just have to touch him to start it, and then after that, there's no range.
Okay.
As long as you are on the same planet. In a plane of existence, technically, which is far beyond just planets. As long as you're in the same dimension, basically.
So don't get
you guys haven't been. You guys haven't been introduced to planes of existence yet. We'll get to that someday. Someday. So you we can change those later, but
while we're waiting. This is what Mrs. Magna just baked me. I don't know if you can see that. It's a pumpkin loaf, and it is delicious. It's so good.
Located yourself.
It's like
on
the
map.
Sweetest thing
what
ever.
Is that?
Come is close to some water.
Hey, Scarfino, what's going on, man?
I was gonna get his boots wet here in a second.
What is what? So let me describe the room here.
Palma stepped away. I don't know if you want to wait till he gets back.
Oh, I'm sorry. I had this one.
My chat's mad at me because I'm not laughing.
You never laugh unless somebody's dying.
It's very true. Death amuses me.
Indeed. All right. Let me explain this real quick. You guys are actually on a landing.
Sorry, back, guys.
All right. Have you found yourself on the map there, Palna?
The only thing that's here for me is a black screen.
All right, I need you to scroll down to the bottom right.
Oh my god, all right.
And Alafa, your health is like way over.
You didn't increase your max, that's why.
I did increase my max, it lied.
It didn't keep.
I blame you for being in my character sheet at the same time.
I fixed it for you.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Can you guys see that? Hold on. I think you guys can see that now.
Alright.
Alright, yep, I can see me.
Alright. Okay, so, the door has opened. And you stepped out onto a 5-foot-wide landing that is 15 feet above a large open cellar. You've got stone steps on either side that are descending down into that area. You've got another door that is here. That's on the underside. That's under the landing. And you have in this cellar a large stone cistern full of clean water. You've got kegs and barrels lining the walls. It appears to be a normal storage cellar. Really, it's entirely unremarkable.
Wait, there's kegs of beer everywhere. Those are all kegs of beer?
Those are kegs and barrels. You don't
kegs
know what's in
barrels.
Them. You
well,
don't know
I,
what's in them.
I think definitely would like to check place. Those.
All right, what do you have to open up? I guess one of you does have a crowbar. I'm guessing you do, Paul, Mr. Rogue.
Let me take a look.
I have a crowbar.
Okay, all right, awesome. So, anybody who has a method of opening a barrel may do so. Zophie has a crowbar. Wolf, what do you have?
Let's check.
Alafa, I should say.
I have
nothing that would be nice to use besides probably my daggers or short sword.
That was Scarfino's ghost, yes.
Which is not going to be very effective against...
Get out of here, wolf!
Well, no.
Pry a plug open.
That's hard against you know, cured wood. That's not going to be very easy.
No.
Yeah, if you really wanted to, you'd give me a strength check.
Yeah, let's do that.
Alright.
I've got my thieves' tools. I assume there's something in there for breaking into these barrels.
Probably a small crowbar, actually.
Hey, Marcus! Alright, so I'll use those.
That's the most effective way of getting in. Okay, the barrels appear to be full of things like salted pork, salted beef, flour, sugar, apples, and indeed, ale. Are you guys going to move over to those barrels? Can you place yourselves?
Sure. How do I turn my guy? I guess I'll turn my guy first. There we go.
All right. So yeah, that's what you find.
Great. Well, I'm going to take some of these to replenish some of my rations here.
Okay.
Some of the food items, anyways.
That's fine. How many days worth would you like to take?
Just 2 days is fine.
Okay. How about the rest of you guys?
I take 3 days worth. I don't have much in my backpack at the moment anyways.
All right. 2 days.
Okay, so I think I'm back up to 10 days worth of rations.
Go ahead and add those to your character sheets, please.
Sounds about right. Okay, cool. JP.
Somebody roll me a d4, please. Wolf, with that skill check, with that strength check, I will say that, yeah, you can hack in and start getting into one of those barrels. So yeah, you have some success. Clearly you found some stuff, so.
Yeah.
I should not have rolled.
All right. Okay. All right. So... Strife. I'm looking at something on your character at the moment. Alright, that's good to know.
Yeah, I'm muted. We're good though. I was definitely explaining what we're doing, too. It's essentially it's role-playing.
The barrels, Strife.
In your chat.
Sorry, what, Wolf?
You're muted in your chat.
I was, yes.
Okay, I just want to make sure that you saw that. I saw how much you were talking, and like everyone's like, he's muted. We can't hear him.
I was definitely just explaining. I was explaining Dungeons & Dragons to Marcus here. So that worked out well.
Glad you went all that effort. Okay, so Strife, you feel the telltale prick of a short sword slipping into your body as somebody who is standing beside you has managed to get the drop on you.
Do I have a short sword?
I was screaming profanities.
And, let's see. The other one, he is going to... actually, he did not managed to catch either of the rest of you by surprise. So you're going to see this. See them coming in the door right after Strife kind of cries out. So now it is time to get Diggity down and roll some initiative. Let's do it.
Wait.
But he's already dead. He got stabbed.
Oh, that's right. I need to roll your damage. Let's do that real quick.
You say, do I live? Did I survive?
Now, when you say he's already dead, do we just leave? Or
no, he's not dead. He's not dead. He's not dead. However, he did take 6 damage, so...
Okay, I gotta roll initiative, guys.
I'm right through dead.
Oh, I have to select my token first. Okay, we're gonna roll initiative. Can you guys see where I am? I don't think anyone can see where I am. I'm down here.
What is Bitcoin?
What is Bitcoin? It's magical Bitcoin. Internet money.
Everybody will pass out on the explanation of Bitcoin.
It is. That's it magical is internet money.
That's
yes.
What it is.
Oh, Poxy's already here, man. So I am second. No, I'm first. Yes.
I'm going to also say, Strife, since you are now aware of your surroundings rather acutely, you can see that the door has opened. That is how they are approaching you, as a matter of fact. And you see another gentleman behind.
Huh.
That is what you can see. All right, so let's roll their initiative.
I'm so dead.
You're pretty bad off.
So I can do a sneak attack, which is good, according to my class feature. And I can either do a stealth dash or disengage.
Kalna,
yes,
you
good,
are
sir.
First.
Okay, well, I guess... I really want to use these
unfortunately,
arrows.
Sorry, just to clarify, unfortunately, yeah. By you guys, when you were going through the barrels, you made a lot of noise.
Yeah.
Especially Alafa with his, like...
my sword into the barrels.
Yeah.
Okay. I can still do a sneak attack, though, right?
Are you stealthed?
Well, it says... For sneak attack, I can do it once per turn. If you had advantage on the attack, or I don't need advantage if another enemy of the target is within 5 feet, and I don't
that
have disadvantage. Do we have disadvantage?
No, you do not have disadvantage. And
it's
I,
a party
I guess,
bard.
Doesn't say anything that says it has to be melee, does it?
No.
So yeah, no, I get what you're saying. Absolutely.
And I mean, I'm hiding off in the corner here, so.
Yeah. Yeah, another enemy is within... Yeah, no, go for it. You get your extra d6.
Great, so I'm going to do, with my short bow, I'm going to do a stealth attack on, I guess this guy closest to Strith. And sorry, it's Strife, isn't it? I always...
Strife, yeah.
Sure, it used a Y. All right, let me see what else here. Yeah, okay, sounds good. So where are my weapons? Weapons are here. We're going to do a
roll
short bow. And I'm going to attack right there.
You've inherited my dice.
Yeah. Sneak
terrible.
Attack doesn't give you advantage, does it? Yeah, that's a 1. Can I get you to roll a d4, please?
No. Oh, no. This is so bad.
Okay. So that will go wild, and it will actually careem off of the stone edge of the cistern that's there.
Don't hit me with the ricochet.
It's a bit 2 feet. It's a bit 2 feet off the ground is how tall the cistern is, just so you guys are aware. And the water comes almost right up to that edge, and it will tumble into the cistern. It will go into the water and start sinking.
Great. Well, at least I didn't kill Strife, so that's good.
Yeah, exactly.
I've got an alternate move.
Silver lining.
So I think I'm going to stealth it up.
Okay. That's right, because you have that ability. All right, why don't you roll me your stealth check, please?
Stealth is where? That was such a terrible
And then, oh, it's their turn after this. Mm.
Yeah, I'm hidden. They don't know where
There's
I am.
There's a dwarf barbarian we need.
I just, like,
shit.
I just
okay,
melded into the floor.
You are one with the shadows. All right, so this fine gentleman
That's
right
nice.
Up here, he is...
You getting a mic?
I just gotta mute my mic for a second while I'm eating
oh,
some
me?
Delicious things.
Oh, hey, Bolt.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a Bolt.
I fucked
Look
up.
Look at that.
Oh.
Save the day.
I had my wrong fucking camera thing on. Hold on.
Did more kids die?
Yay, Scarfino's here. Let me find where his camera is. Hold on.
Confirmed. 2014.
For the
Scarfino,
record, he's not talking. He's not talking about actual children.
Yeah, I was just gonna say. Did you just say you wish more children died? What?
Yeah.
Do I need to sacrifice a bag of milk to save someone's life, or what's going on?
2 bags of milk and 1 bag of chocolate milk must be sacrificed.
Wow.
That's a lot of bags of milk.
That's I just have this ritual image now in my head of big bag of milk and just stabs it and like milk's like squirting out everywhere. It's like
that milk facial though.
Got white all over his face.
Thank God for the warning labels on this street.
It's milk. I don't know what you sick fucks are thinking.
Kansas
Jeez.
City bread.
Kansas City loyal.
Your green screen's a little messed up, Reed.
Yeah.
I know, it's beautiful.
It's about as straight as you
can't do green screen stuff in here, so it's just...
Nope, can't. This is unfortunate. All right.
I gotta try.
Reed, why don't you roll some initiative, please, before I actually roll my attack roll, just
roll
in case.
Roll your damn 20.
Because
they've gone right into a fight. They've gone right into a fight.
Jesus, you guys.
You gotta show him his character, or you can't roll it.
Whoa! What the hell just happened?
Well, if it makes you feel any better, we almost decided to just burn the whole place down.
Initiative for what? What am I doing?
Roll initiative.
We're about to fight.
It's on your core sheet. Core stats sheet.
I attempted to use a roll command looking for the value of selected token. Okay,
we're trying to use chroma key.
Oh,
here,
okay.
Just because.
All right, there's your guy. Your guy's in the bottom right. He's right there.
In.
Hold on, something's fucked.
I have to scroll the map over.
Yeah, but it's covering my taskbar. Hold on.
Yeah, I'm no, that looks terrible.
Noob.
Noob.
No chroma key for me.
There we go. God.
Damn it.
No good.
Hi, Zeno.
Oh, man. You guys.
I'm dead. So dead.
All right. So, here it comes. Oh, what a whiff. He, after whispering sweet death in your ear and death in your side, you managed to dart out of his the path of his attack as he swings at you again. The other two will instead, actually one of them can't, I don't know if he can really do anything. He's got really bad, this guy back here, he's got really bad line of sight to Olafa. The other guy has good line of sight to Olafa. And they are pulling out their bows. and checking. So here's one on you. What's your AC, Alpha?
It's my AC 14. Yeah,
14. 14, alright, so that's gonna be a hit. Oh no, they don't have bows. Never mind, they don't have bows. But they do have two attacks. So alright, no, Zophie, for you. For you, I'm gonna reroll that attack, Zophie, that second attack. Just cause that was intended to be a bow. Even though I probably shouldn't have fudged that sort of thing. Oh, it's even worse. Ah, right in the gullet.
You should have kept the original.
It wouldn't have mattered. It's oh, wait.
16 armor.
Then that would have hit.
No.
Yeah, it's meet or beat. If you know what I mean.
Hey.
Phrasing. All right. 7 damage. And Zophie, the attack magnet, goes down again. However, you do, if I recall, have a healing potion on you, do you not?
I do, but do I really want to use it while I'm dead?
Did you? Well, it would bring you back up. Now, the question is, did you tell any of the other party members about it?
Nope.
Right, okay. So none of you can act upon that knowledge because none of your characters actually have that knowledge.
Did I just hear that innkeeper talking again?
What?
Right, okay.
All right, so Bolt's going to fall off this 15-foot ledge.
He sounded like the gay innkeeper again for a second there. Like you went into gay innkeeper mode. Anyone else here for me, or is it just me?
Okay, I have my moments. Fuck you. Right.
Maybe okay. The stream has censored you.
The other two. Now, okay, so now that Strith is down, this guy is going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He can actually reach you. 6. And so he's going to swing and a swing. With a miss. And that's a miss. Yeah. Lucky. So he's like, and you're just like, fruit like a butterfly. Sting
just
like
a butterfly.
Horribly deformed magic user. Okay, yeah, and this guy, 3, 4, 5, 6. This guy is only able to attack you with cover, so he's at a negative to try and hit you. But here we go. That's a hit.
He's facing the wrong way, though. He can't hit me.
Oh, shut up.
Whoa!
Behind his back.
There. Is that so better? Violent. You better?
He's still facing the wrong way. There you go.
Good enough. Bite me. Alright, so he manages to get a swing at you over the cistern and checks your arm with his sword.
Just
for 7 damage.
Just as a side note, are these guys giants?
No.
They have really large baby heads?
They're big guys. They're big guys. Oh, and they are wearing red cloaks.
Yeah.
Cloaks make them look bigger.
Just like the gentlemen upstairs were.
Wait, all right, Alanta and... 7?
Yes. 7 damage.
I feel like we're all going to die damage. On this one. This is a bad, bad thing.
Me?
Alof and Bolt, who's going first?
I'm
gonna
go
simultaneously, probably.
Nice, Strudel.
You want to go first, Alof?
Since Bolt was late, Alof can go first.
God, you're so goddamn nice sometimes. So nice.
I know.
I'm attacking him right in front of me.
All right.
God damn it.
That is a miss, unfortunately.
Hold on, isn't there the plus? It's still a miss, though. Did it hit the guy next to him because it was a miss? Like, he just spiraled over there and hit him?
Nope. Sorry. That works.
I was not judging you.
Sorry to say.
I was not judging you.
All right, Bolt. Unless there's anything else you want to do on your turn, Wolf.
Just because you guys can't see, Bolt is actually he's over here.
I will say, because when you're in the heat of battle and things start moving and your observation kind of kicks in. This is just when you're in a life or death situation. That's just one of the things that happens.
Adrenaline rush.
You can see that the cistern beside you is full of clean water, and it is. It looks like it's about 10 feet deep.
He's gonna pee in it. I already know.
Just so you're aware.
Or he's gonna cut off someone's head and put it in it.
It's 2 feet. 2 feet to clear to get to actually reach the water. Okay, Bolt.
Yes, sir.
It is your turn.
Mech roll.
You are on a 15-foot ledge, by the way, so you can either attempt to jump it and hope you don't fuck yourself up, or you can go the slow way and take the stairs.
Can I jump on that guy?
Wow.
You could try.
Run and jump.
You can try.
Is it physically possible for me to run and jump that?
Let's see.
With your little dwarf legs.
Somebody get out a protractor and some string and tell me if it's possible.
I will make this the judgment call.
It's only a 20-foot jump.
It's only a 20 feet.
I need to tie some rope to my
ass. Well, he is 15 feet up as well, so that actually does contribute towards his horizontal.
This reminds me of first year physics. Actually, if I got this question on an exam, this would probably be the coolest professor ever.
You getting this calculator?
You're saying there's a chance.
So you're saying there's a chance.
There's a chance he's going to hurt himself really, really bad. Hey, Demonic. Didn't see you come in. What's up, buddy?
Oh, come on, you stupid thing. Movement. Jumping.
Oh no, Demonic. That's tragic. Well, that's the nice thing with Roll 20. It's online, right? So you always have your character sheets wherever you've got access.
Jumping. Long jump. When you make a long jump, you cover a number of feet up to your strength score if you move at least 10 feet on foot immediately before the jump, which I will say you are. What is your strength score?
With 4 mod. 19.
19.
I like how he's 15 meters up, and he's somehow going to jump 15 feet. He's going
to
do better than...
It's only 15 feet to where he needs to go.
Oh, man.
Well, if he wants to land
on the guy... He's like Olympic long jump.
I am going to say...
I'm all right with cutting him in half on my landing.
Well, decide. Decide what you want to do.
I just want to run as far as I can and land as close as I can and... thrust my axe down forward into the dude, which my axe should have like
I would feet, say 3 feet. I would handle, say right? you actually could land on him.
All right, let's
if
do
you
it.
Wanted.
Yeah, you could do it in real life. I'm just saying you could use roll 20.
Land your axe on him.
You could use roll 20 to enter in all your character sheet information, okay. So you have it with you wherever you go.
You'll land beside him.
I want
You'll
to either. I want to land on him and bounce onto the next guy as my land on him happens, or I would just want to hit one with an axe. Let's go for some crazy shit.
Tell me what you're doing. Tell me what you're doing. Don't give me either.
I'm going to land on him. Land on him.
All right. Roll me an attack roll.
With my weapon or something else?
Yeah. Well, I see what you're saying. You're not okay. You're gonna land on him. Okay.
So,
my god!
Wow.
Every time.
Unbelievable.
Oh my god! Every time he pulls the. What the.
Unbelievable.
I'm so happy.
Wow. All right.
I'm the king of the internet.
Oh my god! Roll me another attack roll, please.
Same weapon.
No, roll your unarmed. Do you have an unarmed? I don't know.
Mm-mm. I've got battle axe, javelin, hand axe.
Roll the battle axe then. I know you have a +6.
Damn,
Jesus
so
Christ. Alright. Yeah, sure. I'm gonna give it to you. You totally land on.
I think he's
you
cheating.
Land on his shoulders.
But he's on my team, so I don't care.
Give me a dexterity check, please. I'm sorry, an acrobatics check.
Can I give you a hell yeah too?
You can.
You
yes.
can if no, you don't, no. unless you roll a one. Yeah.
Acrobatics check.
Yes.
And not that anyone cares about the like reality of the situation, but for a dwarf to jump 15 feet from a standing position, that's like, man, you do squats every day.
He was running. He had a run. Yeah, I'm saying that he was like, and then just took off the edge of that ledge and landed
he heard
on
the fighting
the guy
down here, and he ran down the stairs. Yeah. See what was going on.
Right.
And just
he assumed that there was combat going on.
Even with a run
worked, and
like
you land on the guy.
He knew there was fear down here.
I need you to roll a d6, please.
This is so funny. Well, he definitely just killed that guy though. I'm like bits of sugar for
okay,
my
okay, roll one more, please. I should have roll two, but that's actually
sugar
good.
Kernels.
Okay, so as you tumble into a pile of blades and bodies, you are going to take 2 damage from the fall, basically, because you fell 10 feet, okay? The guy you're landing on takes 5 damage. And roll your damage, please, for your battle axe as you attack the one who's next to Alatha at the same time.
Damage, you said?
Yeah.
The damage on my battle axe that I swung. Just damage.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, just damage. Jesus Christ. Okay.
Wow.
23 damage. Did you just kill
wow.
him?
He just rolled 23 damage. He totally killed the guy. The guy. He was about ready to like stab the Lafa, and the top of his head comes off. It literally just like slides off him slowly at an angle. And this other guy, he's gonna take 5 damage.
Okay, so my character wasn't full health, but I just took off 2 from him.
Oh, shoot, I just added, hang on, I just accidentally took off.
I'm health. Hidden, I am fine, I'm a stealthy guy.
So it should be at 25, right?
No, I only took 5 damage off. What was your what?
27 is my full health.
Yeah, I'm a rogue.
I'm
a
16 of 27, but
yeah, that's where you were at the end of the fight.
Oh, okay.
I'm a rogue thief.
All right. Okay, I got him reduced. All right. All right. Strife, I need you to roll that death saving throw, please.
Not bad.
That's a pass. That is a pass.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah. He's already down. Yeah. Already happened.
Oh,
well, he was pretty low to begin with, and they were making a lot of noise in this room as they entered, and the guy got the drop on him. So he is in need of medical attention, if anybody would like to assist with that. Palna!
Yes.
Wait. I'll wait until after this. I'll wait until after the turn.
Okay.
Okay. So, I guess I'm still going to try and go for this guy over by Strife. So So I'll do a sneak attack.
Okay. It doesn't count because he's not conscious, so he can't contribute towards your sneak attack.
Would I have advantage because I stealthed so well on my last go?
You're correct. I'm sorry. You are stealthed. So because he is not aware of your presence... Actually, let me make sure of that. Let me make sure he's not aware of your presence. I mean, you rolled really, really well, so...
Yeah, I think I had... I like, melded with the floor. Zeno, not a bad idea.
He is totally not aware. Yeah, you have advantage. You have advantage. All right. Not only do you get your sneak attack damage, but you also get that both of those d20s.
Sorry, both d20s?
Click your attack, and it rolls 2d20s, remember?
Gotcha, right, okay. Oh, come on! What a waste!
Well, that is enough to hit, so that's fine. So why don't you give me your damn?
And what do I have, a d4?
All right. So you thunk him in the side with an arrow, exposing your location, of course.
And then I get an extra d6?
You do. So go ahead and roll that d6, please.
There we go. Not bad. Right.
So
8.
That's 8 damage that you get on him. He is bleeding. And not at all happy. Are you going to do anything else?
I am. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to stealth again.
Okay, roll it.
It was either that or I was going to dodge somewhere. But I'm +7 with stealth, so let's try this.
All right. Thank you. Let's see. It is their turn.
Oh, I like how my thing's still
on the screen. This guy is not happy. So let's do an acrobatics. No, I'm sorry. Athletics check for him. Let's see.
Okay.
Oh shit, really?
You didn't almost get banned from the channel, but you definitely got kicked out of raid calls.
So he tries to vault over the cistern wall and utterly
nice
fails.
Delta.
He can't even get himself up over it. So he's gonna end up spending some of his movement on that. Okay, he fails again.
That sucks.
Are you guys seeing this?
It's totally random, though.
It's in the universe. Of the stars.
I mean, if the universe wants that.
He literally spends his entire turn trying to get up over the cistern wall and failing.
Did he fall in and sink to the bottom?
No. No, he couldn't even clear the 2-foot wall.
What it was.
Wow. This is the guy that took out Strife. Yay. Go Strife.
Nice one.
That's super powerful.
All right. The guy who is under Bolt is going to crawl out from under him. Sorry, Bolt. I got to move you here.
Man.
And he will stand up and have a swing. And he'll probably be somewhat like impact.
Hold on, what's my distance? Let me measure here. Oh yeah, I can definitely.
Funny. Don't do it. Don't do it. I see you aiming at me.
Jesus Christ! All right, that's attack number one. Here comes attack number two.
No.
Oh, that's a miss. That's a miss. Nothing. Nothing.
I don't know. I think I'm going to try and get behind this guy.
Is all you. Wow, you guys were worried about the dice screwing you? Check out my turn, okay?
I don't want to hear
it. Alatha, what's going on?
Let's see.
Underbolt.
There's only one guy, that guy that's over there.
Kyatra! I have no idea how to pronounce your name, right, dude. Now. I'm so sorry. That's a great question.
I'm going to go ahead and attack this guy with my bolt.
Let me find out for you.
And I think, let's see, which one would be the best? The best around.
All right, which one were you attacking? The one by bolt?
Yes.
All right.
Now, I'm not sure why he would get an opportunity attack. I just assume you know more than me.
Come back to that question. That's an excellent question. Let's finish this. He's going to take Eldritch Blast
well
to
done.
The face. And you actually do 3 extra damage on your Eldritch Blast at the moment, don't you? Remember? Your second level? All right. So that's going to be 12 damage. Which is going to set him on fire.
Yeah, I figured he would be dead from that attack.
Yeah. And he will try... He will try to vault the 2-foot wall and completely fail. Try and get in the water and completely fail. And instead he will just burn to a pile of ashes by the water. So close to water and yet can't make it.
Because
these guys
are, really
these guys are apparently...
That
yeah,
sucks.
They've like they never had to run an obstacle course.
So if he's dead,
so Quatra in your channel there, Megna, shouldn't he get an opportunity attack? The answer is actually no, because he didn't move out of his range. Opportunity attacks. Oh wait, from Alatha.
Yes, Quatra means bolt.
That is Quatra.
Bolt.
Well, no, bolt. No. He would not get one from Bolt because he didn't move out of Bolt's range. He was still within Bolt's range. That's when it actually happens. Now, he did move out of Alatha's range.
Interesting.
So, Alatha, you could smack him with whatever weapon you've got out.
He's dead, though.
Yeah, I hit him. Finish the job.
I can smack Bolt. Can I smack Bolt with the weapon instead?
No.
You didn't step outside your range.
I just want to hit him with the the shaft of my weapon. Just a little bit.
Just a little bit, just the shaft, just a little bit. So
just
I need to move?
Just the tip?
No, you're fine.
The D20s are rigged.
Well, wait. No, I guess it doesn't matter because Bolt... Or because you took him out anyway. It doesn't really matter.
Right.
Either way,
had a,
he's out.
What, the... The advantage attack thingy.
No. Bolt
and
did
I
not
assume
kill
it's
he
Quatra.
Did not move out of Bolt's
Quatra.
Range.
Like French
that,
four.
That's
but
that's
difference.
That's the way the rule is worded.
Okay, he moved out of my range, not Bolt's range.
Exactly. Okay, so you got one guy left there, Bolt.
Say that one more time.
You got one guy left, up on top.
I want to kill him. I want to jump him. I want to run and jump over this pool and land on this guy and kill him.
Oh, I'm going to laugh if you roll a 3. Roll that extra.
Call me Spine.
I'm sorry.
Call me Spine.
Athletics check. Athletics check.
Is this considered the deep end for Bolt?
It might literally be. It is 10 feet of water.
I'm pretty sure he's shorter than 10 feet.
Where is that athletics check? Oh, my God.
I gotta go get a water.
All
I'll
right,
be back.
Roll your attack roll, please.
It's ridiculous. I quit, too.
Megna just walked away.
What the fuck?
I'm so good at the internet. It's ridiculous. I don't even know what
it's
to say.
It's not the internet. It's the universe that's pulling this data.
It
so,
is.
So good.
These numbers come from space. It's cosmic noise. He is literally being granted these powers by space.
Confirmed, Reed's an alien.
Alien.
Carl Sagan is like your personal guardian angel, dude. If the cosmos is fucking, like, in love with you. Roll an attack roll, please. Roll, stop Magnus stop beaming.
Yolo stop Dwarf beaming saves the day. Bolt is OP. Ban him. Oh, God. Oh, God. All right. Attack?
Yeah. All right, that's a hit. Roll your damn down. Roll your damage. Okay. All right. So you literally, like, put one hand on the cistern wall, vault yourself up, and with your other hand, you have your great axe like this, and you just, as you're flying through the air, you bring it around and cut his head off. And land beside him as he collapses to a heap. Fucking dwarf barbarian ninja over here. Oh, Christ.
Yeah, I don't even understand, guys. It is ridiculous.
Go purchase a lottery ticket. All right. Oh, boy. I don't even...
Yeah.
Now, I don't think I have any, like, healing anything.
So I just came in and beat everybody is what just happened, right?
The funny thing is Shut I was actually late, counting.
Joined in the fight and I killed three dudes.
I was counting on your character to kind of come in and save the day. These were kind of overwhelming odds, especially since Strife got caught unawares. But I didn't expect this.
I'm a goddamn champion.
Yeah, that was
put this on Reddit right now.
360 no scope ace round. Well done.
YOLO swag 420 blaze it. So on a side note, okay. Q, how was the furry convention that you just got back from?
Oh, yes. I fucking hate you.
We've been asking about that. I've been seeing it posted all over Twitter that you went to a furry convention. What'd you go as?
A your furry, mother. Obviously.
We've been talking about this all day. This was the rumor that I was starting in everyone's chat throughout the week while you're gone. And I was just like, yo, Q's at this furry convention. Everyone's going to ask him how it was when he gets back. So how was it?
Oh, I fucking hate you. Okay, I was at a business conference, actually.
That's what they call
furry
conventions now?
I was at the largest tech conference in the world. Tech and business.
No, you weren't, because I wasn't
yes,
there.
Yes, I was.
So Hack Midwest?
Tech, it's actually an acronym, stands for Totally Evil Cats.
Yes, it was Dreamforce.
I heard
yes.
Ylvis, the What the Fox Say guy, was the main band.
No, it was Cake and Bruno Mars, who I gave negative amounts of shits about.
Yo, Cake is the most boring concert I've ever been to. The guy just talks.
Pretty sure both good.
And safety belts.
yeah. Q, this is also probably an important question. Strudel yes. QD427 asks, did you go to the business conference in a fursuit?
I did not. Yeah. However, I did go in my Jedi robe. So, at least I was actually talking. I was speaking at this conference. And I did actually speak. Do one of my presentations, because I had multiple, in my Jedi robes. So, that's awesome. I did wear something.
Did you use the Force?
A fursuit underneath the Jedi robe.
I forced? Yes. There was Force involved.
And from right. Magnus chat, Bolt can fight a dragon and kill it with his nipples.
He does have some pretty razor sharp nipples.
Yes. And Magna points out, or I'm sorry, in Magna's chat, Ukrainian Bard points out, I see Q sweating. Yes, that robe is hot. That is a hot robe. I ended up actually doing that presentation in the robe on the stage of a movie theater with lights coming down. That kind of sucked a bit.
Report back to everybody when I talk to him about the furry convention at work tomorrow.
I hate you. Okay.
Continue with the game.
With the game. This seems like an appropriate time, as much as anything, to remind you all that if you're enjoying what you see here, that we are taking part in a special event this Saturday called Extra Life, supporting the Children's Miracle Network. We are helping to pay for children who can't afford their medical treatment. kids who literally have life-threatening diseases or conditions, and we are raising money to help them so that they can get help. And we are taking donations. I have a link on my page at twitch.tv/webadatgames. It's right below the Twitch stream. I've got my cards down at the bottom, and there's a donate link that is on the little image that says Extra Life. And click that. If you like what we're seeing here, please feel free to give money to the kids.
Thanks, JP.
Not to me. It's going to the kids. For the kids.
Not the one Scarfino was killing, by the way.
Yeah, I haven't looked at this all weekend either, and we're up another, like, $1,800. That's cool. $12,869.
Yeah, I've got some coming in, too. Got some coming in, so. Please. For the kids, yes, it's tax deductible. There is a receipt that you can download. You will receive that. You can fully verify it if you go to extralife.com, extra-life.com. It's got all the credentials and everything. It's important. It's important.
Thanks, Q.
And Reed has actually had the chance to meet some of these kids. Have you not?
Yeah, I got my ass kicked in Madden by one of them.
All right. So, you have cleared the room.
You're welcome.
And you have a Strife on the ground, and he's bleeding out. Somebody gonna help him?
Help me.
Does my spit heal things?
No. That's your tears.
Can I cry on him and he'll heal?
That's the problem.
Do I have stuff to help him? Do you need a bandage or something? Do I have to do
some magic? Cry. You never cry.
Well, that's why this is going to be difficult. I'm going to have to roll high to cry.
How about you roll?
Does he just need a bandage?
If you're going to help him, you can roll a heal check. Or medicine check, I'm sorry. Medicine check.
I'm going to
try. They fucking changed that in 5th edition. It's called a medicine check now.
I think I should go help him. We'll see what happens.
All right, well, that's not going to help. Bolt's like...
Did I make it worse?
On the wound.
I just pounding on it.
Get better!
All right, I'm gonna see if I can help here.
Zophie, can I get you to roll a death saving throw, please? Oh, that's a failure. All right, so one pass, one fail. Paolo, why don't you have a go?
Probably a bad idea.
Don't roll one. Well, it's not a one.
It's not a one. It's damn close, though.
Sophie, how about another death saving throw? I'm actually being a bit harsh with this, but... Oh, that's two!
I'm gonna take a quick look. I guess in his pockets. I want to see if he's got anything on him that might be of use.
Come on, right.
Strife,
yeah.
You will in fact find a small vial that says healing on it.
Well, I'm going to, slip that down his throat.
All right.
I'll pour it out, not the whole vial.
Oh, all right. Okay. Because that would have been funny. All right. So I believe that is a D6 you should roll then, Zophie.
I officially kill Strife.
Sure, I should be rolling this.
Hey, I'm the sorry, crazy, what's
D4.
Going on?
2D4.
Neo, good to see you, man. Hello, hello.
All right, 2d4 plus 2, so you are now at 7 hit points. Congratulations, you are conscious, awake, and no longer dying.
Strife, I hope you don't mind me going through your things. But wasn't sure what we were going to do about you.
Look away my healing potion.
All right. Bolt, you can see this is an open room.
I like to check the barrels for liquor.
They already discovered that there is, in fact, ale.
I want it.
There's also some other supplies.
I want to own it. Yes, there's a yeah, but he I pointed out what was relevant to him. Left it at that. Yeah, there is salted pork, salted beef, apples.
Hey, what's ale? This?
What's what?
That health bar hiding behind the wall
right
there.
That's Nima. Yeah, that's Nima.
Oh, is Nima? I was saying, I want to check out behind that wall. I want to see what's behind that wall.
No, just Nima.
It just randomly knocks on the wall.
This is completely cleared. We've cleared all of this.
Yeah, I will say Nima was staying behind to help dispose of the bodies. He's doing the burying.
He
drew the short
straw.
Can I inspect the pool?
There's another thing over here. Thing.
Why don't you roll an investigation check, please?
He doesn't need to. I'll explain it to him since we've already inspected it.
Yeah, maybe I'll see something you didn't see.
There's nothing in there. It's clean. Clean water.
You didn't see anything anyway.
I'm dumb as fuck. Is that concrete? Is that mud?
Can you even see over the wall there?
It's actually very clean water. I'm sorry. You know what? I had to roll the wrong thing. Roll perception.
Watch it still be a 2.
Yeah, that'd be fun. All right. You perceive that it is in fact clean water.
That's it. It's just clean water.
Did you see anything I didn't see, bro?
Yeah, I was like, do I know it's 10 feet deep?
Yes, it's 10 feet deep.
Nothing in it. It's just water.
Yeah, just water.
I want to drink some.
Thank God.
All right.
Thank God.
I need you to enjoy that water because it is clean and cool and tastes all great.
Right. All right, fine. Fuck. I was thinking they kept running for the water when we were fucking them up. So I was thinking maybe there's something with the water. Like if we drink it, we become superhuman or something.
Are you So, okay, are you guys looking through the other room as well?
Yeah. Is that my turn? I'm done. I can't go look at stuff.
We're not really taking turns.
Well, guys,
what are you guys doing?
What do you guys think this is used for? I mean, have you seen one of these before? Do you guys know, like, is this just drinking water for the Red Brands?
I think it's a bathhouse.
Cigar, we already have, we have searched it.
They weren't able to get in it very easily.
Quadra,
so
thanks for the follow. Welcome to the Magnation.
My real question, though, not to skip over the important question of what it's used for, my question is, there was 3 of them and only 2 beds. Who was bunking with who?
I think they make liquor here. They make ale. Make ale here because there's a lot of ale in
the world. May never know. The world may never know.
I think we should check out the other room.
I agree. Definitely need to check out the other room. I'm gonna take a drink. I'm thirsty. Delicious clean water. I'm proposing,
exactly,
since this could be a water source for the Red Brands, that we poison the
Palna
water source.
Oh, he's in hose.
Hey, Palna.
Hey.
Hey, Palna.
Hey.
Hey. Gone. Can you roll perception check, please?
Son of a gun.
The water makes Palna extremely attracted to Bolt.
Damn, minus 1.
That's some nice water. You feel great.
Oh, crap. It's delicious.
We're gonna have the shits here in the next turn or 2. I think it's what's gonna happen.
Such a bad idea.
Everybody drink the water, so we're not alone.
As you search the other room, you find the crates and barrels. They actually contain much the same. The main difference is that there are in fact 3 red cloaks hanging from hooks above the beds.
Dibs.
Wait, they have 3 extra cloaks.
Yes, 3 extra cloaks.
We take them.
Okay. You now have cloaks. Congratulations.
So it's not worthwhile to poison this water more?
Poison it.
Well, to be fair, Bolt, I thought you were going to take a leak in it, so that's why I drank before that happened, but...
All right, sorry. What's going on?
So, nobody has poison on them? Nobody?
Somebody do something.
I don't have any poison.
I don't know, do you regularly carry poison?
Well, I don't know if someone picks something up in town. I don't know.
Poison.
Do you normally carry
Oh no, Bolt has started to act strange already. This isn't a good sign.
That's what he said. I was repeating.
All right. What's going on?
I think we should pour the leftover ale that we did not take with us. Or has Bolt finished drinking it all yet?
He does, JP.
All I want to know is that there was only 3 cloaks and there's 4 of us. Who doesn't get a cloak?
I call dibs. I mean, I call dibs. With disguises and that sort of thing, I'm taking one.
I will point out that Bolt, that cloak is going to be trailing on the ground for you. Just saying.
Sorry, somebody subscribed and it was loud and I didn't hear anything you guys just said.
That's
amazing.
I was saying the cloak is like trailing on the ground, like there's like 2 feet left behind.
That's fine with me. That's perfect. I love it.
Alright, just saying.
I'm gonna wrap it around me like a loincloth off the bottom part.
This is such a bad idea.
Oh, he's gonna wrap it under his junk. Did I mention these were already quite dirty? Okay, on that note, what are you guys doing?
Anything else? I want to look under the beds. I want to look under the beds.
Bolt now has Ebola.
On his balls. Ebola.
Ebola.
You managed to find and quickly slay the dust bunnies that are residing under the beds.
You are just witty as fuck tonight. Jeez.
I'm on fire.
This is ridiculous. All right, so there's nothing under the bed. So, no. All right, I'm going to jump up on one and take a nap next.
So, Bolt, bed, and starts looking like he's getting really comfortable and ready to sleep. What are you guys doing?
Yeah, Bolt, get out of there. We are definitely not camping out in their base of operations. I'm sure once these...
But Ben, I'm tired.
I'm sure once these guys do not... go back to wherever they came from. People are gonna come looking for them.
Just wake me up when you guys are done. I just killed everybody. Just wake me up when you're done. Alright.
I swear to God, Bolt.
Because Father Figure Pound, just kicked me out of the room. I gotta leave. I gotta leave the room. I walk away like... God, I'm
back in my hand, son.
I'm away. I walk away. I say, go ahead. Check it out.
Okay. What are you guys doing?
I'm going to take one quick look around for any sort of passages, secret passages, anything. I'm just going to check the perimeter of the rooms here.
All right.
I would suggest a Bolt to grab some rations from these containers before we leave.
Other than the ale.
You know what? I'm all sorts of confused. Because I was under the impression that you should be rolling investigation. However, this may not be the case. So I need to determine what investigation truly is. Give me one moment.
You screwed up.
Apparently.
No, we gotta restart the whole game.
Apparently, damn. It has more to do with deduction, detective work. It's deduction. Investigation is a deduction check. Well, that's stupid. And they call it deduction instead of investigation.
Just to confuse you.
Please roll perception check, Mr. Pelna, for your searching.
Ah, well then. The question then, does that change my stats at all?
No, does not.
Okay.
I have a question for you. This water basin here in the middle, is there water flowing into it, or can I tell if water is flowing out of it, like down a drain?
There are drain pipes that are appear to be leading into the cistern. However, at the moment, there is no water pouring out of them into the cistern.
Okay, so it's just still water right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, Palmer, that was your... Okay.
DSM, what's up, dude?
You Sweet Kazan, what's up? Anything out of the ordinary in this room.
Alrighty. Well, I say we burn it. Burn it all.
There is a door leading out.
There's a passage that we haven't discovered yet, or went into yet.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, my bad. Sorry, when Bolt said he went in the other room, I thought that's the room he was talking about.
No, he meant this room.
Gotcha, okay, yeah. I say we burn.
Not yet. We're not burning it yet.
For the record,
we burned it on our way out.
The cellar you are in is made of stone. Not really going to burn.
I don't know, there's quite a bit of ale here. We could try
it. It might explode.
Right, and the roof above, the ceiling, right? It's the flooring from upstairs.
Your ceiling, your roof right now is stone.
Ah, interesting, okay.
Foundation.
Yeah.
How does that work?
Let's check out this other room if we're done here. I'm not going first.
We are at...
what's your marching order?
Sort of an abandoned building, chasing down the Red Brands, leader of the Red Brands.
I'm going to stay behind Bolt, as his skills are way too impressive for me to stand in the way of.
Oh, Strith, don't you move the size, or Strith, goddammit. You're in front of me. You're my shield.
Barbarian the security cat.
Yeah, is that the door? Is that the way out, you're saying? Right there?
Yeah, that little white thing that...
Palma, hitting the charge.
Over.
Yeah. All right,
fine. I'll go second. Pansy Barb.
To clarify, guys, I'm actually standing on the ledge just above the room.
Oh, you're not actually going up to the door.
I will stand in front of the door if Strith is scared.
Bolt, you're up first.
Unless Strith wants it. You want it? You want first?
Not with four health, I'm not.
Okay, I'm first.
Go. So, there's a normal handle on the door.
Thanks for the explanation, Q. It's way better than mine.
You open that door?
You're in the wrong place, Bolt.
All right. Yeah.
I want to be in front of the... What?
You should be where Pelna is. Yeah. I am. As you open the door, you see in front of you... Room.
Oh, God.
Interesting.
Can I move ahead?
Sure. Why not?
How far?
Go ahead and step up. Step up, Mr. Bolt.
Yes, we did.
Damn, look at this, guys. There's so much space. Come on up here.
Alrighty.
You have now stepped into a long hallway. There's a thick layer of dust covering the floor here. There is faux columns along the walls.
What did you say?
Doors. Faux.
Oh, faux. Okay. I was like, what the fuck? Faux column. Faux columns. Why do I feel like Spike's going to come shooting down this hallway at us like traps or something?
There is a double door at the end.
The bolt just charges down. Plate. Don't worry, it's
bolt. Okay, wait, whoa, whoa, bolt, bolt,
bolt. That was a misclick, sorry, misclick.
I need you to roll an acrobatics check, please.
Okay, damn it.
I you wouldn't have heard this, but I fully just said in my chat. I
you're saying on your lips. You go, he just rushes down the hallway.
Not an acrobatics check. I'm sorry. It should be a dexterity saving throw.
Oh my god.
It's traps. It's totally traps.
After you called it, too.
I know. Fuck. Don't. Oh, I have acrobatics dexterity? What? Oh, I see it. Dex saving throw. There it is. You ready?
Alav is gone.
Dex saving throw, right?
Yep. Alav, are you leaving?
This feels like a trap.
Okay.
We're all gonna die. I should have stayed out of there.
Bolt, as you're like, hey, part. Check out this door. That's pretty... The floor gives way underneath you. You attempt to catch yourself on the edge and don't quite make it. And fall 20 feet. So I need you to roll... 2d6, please.
His short little legs aren't going to be able to save him.
Are you trained in acrobatics, by the way?
He's a dwarf. They're not trained in acrobatics.
You lucky son of a bitch.
Wow.
No, I'm not proficient in it.
All right.
I have a 2. It's a 2.
He landed on his beard.
Yeah, he landed on... So you take 3 damage. That's pretty good. That could have been 12. That's, you got lucky. That's amazing. There. But you have landed prone. You are.
Give me one sec, guys. I'll be right back.
Beat the fuck up. Oh, also, I'm sorry. I forgot. Gentlemen.
Is it 2 damage or 3?
3 damage.
Magic of 3.
3 damage.
Here we go again. What are we doing?
I need each of you. I need each of you to take 75 experience points for that fight.
Sweet, thank you. Where do I add
please
this?
Please add that to your sheet. Paulna, take 75 experience points for that fight.
Yeah, I got it. Perfect. Thank you, man.
Excellent. All right.
Wait, why did he get 75?
Everybody does.
We all do.
You get 75, 75. You get 75. You get 75. Everybody gets 75.
All right, Oprah.
All right.
Okay, the next level is 900 XP, by the way.
Now Bolt is at the bottom of a pit, laying on his ass. Probably hurting a little bit. What do you guys
I
think?
Know, Neo. Should have been spikes.
I'm laughing.
All right. Pretty well, hysteria. I'm going to very carefully tiptoe my way over to the edge. I'm sort of testing the floor as I go. I'm got my hand on the walls. I'm sort of looking for any sort of potential traps that might be here as well. And I'm gonna take. I've got rope in my pack. I'm gonna throw down some rope for him to climb back up on.
Okay.
So generous.
All right. Bolt, how about you roll an athletics check to climb that rope? Because this would be funny.
That's great, Wolf.
Okay, you're fine. You crawl out of the trap. Now... here's the deal, people. This, move Bolt to where he should be. This whole area, oh, god damn it. I want blue. Is now a pit. There is a thin ledge around the sides.
I'm just gonna leap it.
That someone who is particularly agile might be able to
cigar boss,
sidle along. Other than that, you got a 20-foot pit to cross.
Sorry, that's 20 feet or 10 feet?
I'm sorry, 10 feet. You're correct. 20 feet deep.
I'm going to leap it.
Okay. And your strength is...
Strength is minus one. Nine.
No, total. What's nine? Okay. Give me untrained intelligence check, please.
I do have a, I guess that doesn't count. I was thinking, acrobatics would work for this, but no.
That doesn't enter into it in this particular case. And actually, jumping is athletics, not acrobatics, but neither of them are going to directly apply here. I will accept an athletics roll or an untrained intelligence check. Up to you.
Didn't think that through. Sorry, where's the intelligence check? Is that on my core stats?
That is on your core stats page. Yes, it is.
Or on your skills at the bottom.
Should be saving right throw? By your intelligence.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
That'd be fine, I think.
Okay.
So there's a saving throw, and then there's the intel check on your skills page.
Oh,
it's
sorry.
On the skills page. It's unskilled. Unskilled. Which is, I think it's going to be the same, so...
Oh, okay, further down, I see ya. Yep. One sec. No, I'm breaking stuff,
okay.
Hold on.
I'm just going to accept the 10 that you rolled, that's fine. You're not quite sure you're going to make that. That's a close one for you.
Is this just a check to see if you think you're going to make it?
Yeah. How about you other guys?
I'm going to roll it as well, just to see.
Okay. How big is the beds in the other room?
The beds are, well, let's just go by looks. They are about 7 feet long, about 4 feet across. And,
also crafty.
And
nice.
They
TV.
Are probably not of the highest quality make. But they would have a very rudimentary.
My half elf and I
probably
can't do
only
nothing.
About,
terrible news.
I don't know, 3 inches wide or tall. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But there
the
are
check
a couple.
I need to roll.
Zophie, you have no clue. Paulina, you already rolled one, so.
What do I need to roll?
Intelligence check or a athletics check, either one.
Yeah, sorry, I was just doing that to make sure I got the I know.
Although,
where it is
for frankly, Bolt, you know you can make this. You've made longer than this. You just did make longer than this, so no, you're
and
fine.
And then I fell down an obvious hole.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you're good at jumping when you know it's there.
Am I able to throw Palna across it so he can make it?
You could assist.
I would like
you
to
could
assist
Palna
in getting him across. Getting him across.
Why not?
Sure
let's do
it.
You accept his help? All right. All right.
I was going to shimmy across the ledge, but this sounds way better.
I like Alapa's idea.
What was that?
Of making a bridge.
Maybe able to use
sorry.
What Magna has.
Sorry, who said that? who said that?
All I see is a head, a forehead. What is that?
I don't know where Zophie went.
Zophie was here, apparently.
Zophie, sponsored by Game Wagers. Game-Wagers.com. Game-Wagers.com. If anyone wants to check out the site, Game-Wagers.com.
What the fuck, dude?
Acorn, yeah.
All right. Interesting. When you're helping another creature, you don't actually have to roll.
Friendship.
It's because of that hard beard.
All right, so Palma, I need you to roll an athletics check with advantage. As you get halfway tossed across. All right, yep, you clear it. You land with both feet right on the other side and stumble forward.
That's real close,
forward.
Guys.
Wolf, would I be able to use a rope? Magna hasn't tied the bed together to make it as and make sure it's pretty high. Maybe. Depends on how well you crafted it. That's a possibility. Yeah.
I feel like if I jump, I'm going to be the only one that falls.
What? Did you have
I help him too?
Do you have any specifics? Yeah, you could.
Friendships?
I'm still on the other edge helping throw them across, right? I'm picturing me crouched going like this, letting them run and jump off my feet, off my hand, and I push up like that.
And you push
That's
up.
How I'm picturing it. Yeah, I do push up. Push All up. Right. Yeah.
And then since Palna is now on the other side, he could help catch.
Hey.
If you know what I mean.
Sounds good. Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like he'd get hurt because he's like a little elf guy.
Little elf guy. I'm like twice the size of you.
Hey, I got girth. I got girth. I'm a girthy dude.
Yeah, thick, we'll go with
thick
that.
Old dwarf
you're twice the size of me as well, but in this direction.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's thick, all right. Real thick.
No one tosses a dwarf. No one. Good old Lord of the Rings. Wow.
What? Okay, that's just wrong. So what's happening?
I'm going to run and jump.
You going to run and jump? You going to use me? You want my help?
I'm going to use you.
All right, let's do it.
All right, roll with advantage.
Is Strife dead or is he alive this time?
He's currently conscious. He is currently conscious.
All right, what am I rolling?
Roll athletics check, please, with advantage. Actually, what is your strength? I'm sorry, what is your strength score? Not your modifier, your score.
My strength score is 13.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you make it across.
Okay. Just like that, huh? Okay.
Yeah. What's your strength score, Zolfi?
15.
All right. What are you doing?
Jumping across with Bolt.
Okay. All right.
An offer to help.
You make it across.
I'll help. I'll help.
It's garbage. Alafa, I need to go do squats assuming. Or something.
Yeah.
Alafa.
I missed leg day. It was earlier. That's why I was late. It was leg day.
Hey, Michael.
With his help, Alafa, you basically launch into the opposite doorway. Just since you got that 20.
Yeah. I'm no longer on the screen.
Nope, you are not. You went through the door. All right. So in front,
I gotta make it across.
I hope you hurt someone.
Yeah. Now Bolt has to make it across. What are you doing, Bolt?
I want to run and jump across.
Okay. All right. That's fine. You can make it to the other side. Okay. So you now have a door in front of you. It's a copper plated double doors.
It's not too bad, Michael.
Over the door is the graven image of a mournful angel.
Is that angel naked?
It's only the top half. Like, or not even top half. Idea. It's like here.
See you see there?
You see
Hashtag
it.
Archetype.
Hashtag naked angel.
I see what you were with that. So, what are you guys doing?
I want to walk in and check it out. What do you guys want to do?
I was already in there.
Okay, Alafa opens the door.
I have a bad feeling about this.
I was being facetious. There are totally doors there.
Damn. All right, I open the door and walk in.
All right.
Now you know, what's up, everybody? I don't do that.
You are met with silence as you enter the open mausoleum.
Oh, God. Skeletons, we're going to have to battle the undead. Cannot wait.
Those are no problem.
There are three large stone Sarcophagi.
I'm gonna call it that.
Yes, sarcophagi.
I feel like that's the end of a joke.
What? In this dusty crypt.
Why are they coffins?
Leaning up against each of the sarcophagi is a human skeleton.
The answer is because the DM said.